And no one will be able to move into the View Apartments. That's from the city engineer, who says he won't sign off on the project until Stadium Drive is complete. 4029's Ben Wagner's been following this story and explains where hundreds of students will now stay. He's live in Fayetteville tonight. Ben?
Yeah, we're across the street from the View Apartments, Angela, where you can see the road looks nearly finished. That's Stadium Drive here right behind us. Workers out here late, boy, past 9 o'clock, trying to put the finishing touches on this road. But city leaders say it's not good enough, and the apartments up the hill will be empty this weekend.
It'll take whatever time it takes.
That's from Fayetteville's city engineer, Chris Brown, the man who heads the roads inspection when it's finished. Today, workers finished paving the last few hundred feet on Stadium Drive, but torn up sidewalks and construction clutter will put the final inspection off until at least Monday.
All of those things need to be 100% complete, so the residents who are moving in don't have to drive through a construction site, dodge heavy equipment, possibly run over nails, construction debris, etc.
The rain kept builders behind schedule all week. The delay will keep another 300 students from moving in Saturday. That's on top of 350 others who already know their apartments wouldn't be ready and planned on staying at a hotel.
This is really a long-term project that's going to be here for a long time, and it's not worth a few days to, you know, to sacrifice safety of the residents.
Builders are crunching to get those tasks done so they can get their occupancy certificates. Those pass through a number of different city department heads. Construction teams will need them so students can move in. And the city engineer also told us that he'll have inspectors out here all through the weekend to take a look at some of those smaller tasks that they have to look at here on the road right here behind me, though he did say the final inspection won't be until Monday at the very earliest. Reporting live tonight in Fayetteville, I'm Ben Wagner, 4029 News.
There's going to be a lot of upset students. 4029 also spoke to the project manager on site. He says he doesn't have any idea as to when his teams will finish the job. Now, safety has been a big concern at the View this year. In April, the project was shut down for several weeks because of a fire violation. A worker was buried alive and killed while digging a ditch on May 5th. A little more than a month later, June 9th, a construction truck hit a power line at the site. A second worker died on site. He was electrocuted. Three other people were taken to the hospital. Then on June 20th, hundreds of gallons of fuel spilled into a nearby dry creek.